Rod Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today's pseudonym's nursery rhyme of hijacking. Once upon a truck. Starring Joe Campanella. In a Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company and Lazy Boy Recliners. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Prison he went, his time was well spent. Now he'll be with his niece and her hubby. Today, the story of a rehabilitation, a man changed. His only problem is, the world that sent him away hasn't. Listen now to Once Upon a Truck.
Hey, Jasper, wait up.
I'm sorry to be this way, Kermit, but that ceremony got me right here. A beautiful funeral.
Wheels was the best long-distance trucker I ever had. Good guy. Heart came out on him.
I guess I'm getting old. Back in the old days, one of the boys clocked up and it was no big deal. Part of the game.
Well, Jasper, the rules are different then. With you, me, and good old Tubby. Now, there was a talent.
How long has Tubby been away?
Oh, must be 20, 25 years by now.
Wonder if he's still alive.
Most likely ate himself to death in prison or got himself killed one way or the other. Tubby was a mean old cuss.
Yeah, we all were then.
Yeah, that's the way of the world, Jasper.
Poor Tubby.
Oh, come on, Jasper, chin up.
I guess I'm getting old.
Rosie, I'm home.
So soon?
Yeah, I'm tired. Give me a beer.
I'll get it yourself. How much did you steal today?
$4 and change.
The kid next door steals more off newsstands. It's gonna be some sweet job explaining you to my uncle.
What uncle?
Tubby Garfinkel.
He's still alive?
You better believe it, and you better shape up. This telegram came while you was out picking up pennies. It's from the warden. Uncle Tubby's getting out on Monday, and since I'm his only living kin, he'll be staying here with us.
Why here? Ain't we got enough trouble getting by? How do you expect me to steal enough for trade?
Don't make me laugh. You're minor league compared to Uncle Tubby. He's the toughest man this town's ever known. Toughest and the smartest.
You got sent up for murder. You call that smart?
Don't you let him hear you talk to me that snippy like that.
That old geezer, he must be 60 years old by now. The world has changed.
Not enough to stop Uncle Tubby. He's still got connections. Jasper Sykes and Kermit Wiley used to be his partners. They were all in the hijacking business together.
But Rosie, Sykes, and Wiley have been legit for 20 years. They both own their own company.
And they owe it all to Uncle Tubby. They made their money using his technique.
Yeah, but like I said, the world has changed.
We'll see about that on Monday.
I can wait. Now, how about that beer?
Get it yourself.
Well, Tubby, the time has finally come. You've paid your debt to society. You're free to return now.
Oh, gee, Warden Congreve, I don't know what to say, except that I'll miss you. You too, Dr. Needles. Hey, you'll look into my plants, won't you, Doctor?
Every day, like I promised. And don't forget your medication.
Oh. Tubby, I gotta warn you that things are different on the outside. Different from in here and, well, radically changed from the way they were 25 years ago.
Oh, I've changed too, Warden. I guess I won't be needing my old clothes. Well, you look at the size of them trousers. Did they really fit me?
Don't you remember? They were tight. Very tight. Now, Tubby, the bus will take you into Harcourt, and your niece Rosie is expecting you. You'll be staying with her and her husband.
Oh, little Rosie. My, it's been a long time. She was just a little girl. You think she'll remember me?
Well, one thing for sure. She won't recognize you.
Oh. Yeah?
Are you Deke Thornhill?
Yeah, that's right. Who are you?
My name is Tubby Garfinkel. You Rosie's husband?
You're Tubby Garfinkel?
That's
Where
right.
Where is it, Deke?
Come on in, Uncle Tubby.
Rosie?
Uncle Tubby? Wow, welcome home. Hey, Deke, how about fixing Uncle Tubby a drink?
Oh, Lord, don't bother. I never touch the stuff.
But I thought people say you used to really put it away.
Oh, things change, Rosie, dear. Do you mind if I sit down?
Oh, yeah, sit right here.
Thanks. I'm a little tired from the trip. What a comfort to these old bones.
It must feel real good to be out, huh, Uncle Tubby?
Oh, in a way. Oh, sure, lots of folks around nowadays.
Hey, got any plans, Uncle Tubby? I mean, about a job or something?
Oh, got a few things in mind.
You going to work alone?
I don't think so. I may hook up with some outfit.
Sykes and Wiley are still around.
Jasper and Kermit, how are they?
Oh, they're big men these days. Truckers, both of them. They went straight.
Of course, with you back in town, they might think about changing back.
Oh, I wouldn't want them to do that.
What do you mean? What kind of things do you have in mind?
I'd like to work with flowers.
What are you talking about, Uncle Tubby?
Well, I was head gardener at the prison for over 15 years. I learned a lot about flowers, especially roses. They made me think of you, Rosie, dear. Did I say something funny?
Uncle Tubby, you'll have to tell us all about it.
Be quiet, Dick.
My, oh, how things have changed. Hello?
Dick, where's Uncle Tubby?
He's here, sleeping. Where are you?
Downtown.
Well, get on back here, Rosie. I ain't wasting a whole day babysitting.
I'll be back as soon as I can. Now keep an eye on Uncle Tubby. We need him for what we're going to do. I'll tell you about it when I get there.
Come in. Hello, miss. Do I know you?
Indirectly. May I sit down?
Hey, go right ahead.
My uncle sent me to see you. He'd come in person, but he's awful busy.
Yeah, who's your uncle?
Tubby Garfinkel.
Well, you don't say.
Yeah, prison life didn't affect him, Mr. Wiley. He's still big, mean, and nasty, and he's itching to get back to work.
Well, I guess I could find an easy desk job for an old friend.
That's not what Uncle Tubby had in mind, exactly.
What do you mean?
You were his partner once, weren't you? You and Mr. Sykes?
Yeah, that was 25 years ago.
Well, that's how he wants it to be again.
Miss, times change.
That's what I told him, but you know my Uncle Tubby, he's stubborn. He wants you and Mr. Sykes to know that he's back and what his demands are.
Demands? Now, look, lady, I didn't get to be where I am by copping to every cheap threat that came my way.
Goodbye, Mr. Wiley. It's been real nice knowing you.
Jasper, I want you to meet a friend of mine, Semi Conlon. He's a new driver I just hired.
Kermit, Tubby's back.
Well, the girl came to see you, too, huh?
She could make trouble for both of us.
But, Jasper, you sound scared.
You remember how Tubby gets when he doesn't get his way?
I'd like to hear what Tubby has to say personally, face to face. Then maybe we could work something out. If not, well, that's where Semi comes in.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
Things have changed, Jasper, but sometimes the old ways come in handy. You get my drift?
I get it.
Hey, now, wait a minute, Kermit. I'm against any violence.
So am I, but Semi doesn't see things the way we do.
What are you going to do?
Nothing for now. The next move is theirs. But if they think I'm handing over my business, they've got another thing coming.
Kermit, we got to stick together on this.
Fine. Well, what do you say we do?
I don't know. I'll think of something.
Yeah, you do that, Jasper. I'll make it soon.
Deke?
Well, you sure took your time getting back.
I had to go to a warehouse to find Sykes, but I think it was worth it. He's a soft touch.
What about Wiley?
Oh, he comes on strong, but he ain't so tough.
Like Uncle Tubby.
Oh, lay off. By the way, where is Uncle Tubby?
In there, sleeping.
Oh, still.
Where you going?
Wake him up. I want to talk to him about technique. Uncle Tubby? Hey, what's this?
What's a what?
Deke, you fool. Here, read it for yourself.
Dear Rosie, it was such a beautiful day outside, I decided to go for a walk.
I didn't want to wake your husband, so I went out to find...
Just who's been sleeping around
Rosie,
here?
Rosie, I might have dozed off for a second, but...
Oh, can't you do anything right?
We can find him. He can't be too far away.
We haven't time for that. Someone might recognize him.
That old broken-down bag of bones.
Well, I have to work fast. We'll hijack one of Sykes' trucks. He'll pay plenty to get it back, and he'll think Uncle Tubby did it.
You know, that ain't a bad idea. Who will you get to hijack the truck?
You.
Good news, Mr. Garfinkel. Warden Congreve says you're first rate. That's good enough for me. You're hired.
Oh, it's great, Mr. Frieselbit. I can't thank you enough. Flowers of my life.
Start at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning.
I'll be here right on time, Mr. Frieselbit. And thanks again.
Mr. Wiley. You back so soon?
Yeah, been a rough week.
Not another funeral?
I'm afraid so.
Well, I guess you'll be needing another wreath. Did another of your truck drivers pass away?
No, this one was an old friend. A big, mean, very fat old friend. May he rest in peace.
Sykes' trucks? The driver's on ice.
Good. I sent a telegram. Sykes should contact us soon.
What do you want me to do now?
Stay put. You're at the site Uncle Tubby used to use?
Yeah. Boy, he must have been something in his time. No one in a million years would think of looking for a hijacked truck up here. Nice and isolated. Hey, did the old buzzard show up yet?
Not yet. I'm still waiting for him.
Well, I'd love to see Sykes' face when he opens that telegram.
Yeah, me too, but I'll settle for the money.
Hey, I gotta go. The driver's coming, too. I guess I didn't smack him hard enough. Talk to you later.
Hello? Yeah, this is Wiley speaking. What? When? I thought it was a bluff. Well, this means war.
Gee, boss, you look mad. What happened?
One of our trucks got hijacked in broad daylight.
What
are you laughing about?
I get to go to work now.
Yeah, I guess you do. But no, not just yet. We're going to pay Jasper Sykes a little visit first.
Hello?
Rosie, I got bad news.
Now what?
The truck I snatched.
From Sykes?
That's the bad news. It didn't belong to Sykes. It's Wiley.
Oh, you idiot.
How can I know? They all look alike.
Stay there. Don't do anything. I'm on my way up.
Come here. Okay, Jasper, I'm through waiting.
Want me to nail him, boss?
No. Jasper, you know anything about one of my trucks getting hijacked?
One of your trucks?
No, boss.
Relax, semi.
This telegram says one of my trucks got it. But none of mine are missing.
Well, one of mine is. Let me see that telegram. Huh. Yeah, signed Tubby Garfinkel.
Well, if Tubby hijacked one of your trucks, why would he send that to me? He's no fool.
Well, somebody is.
Come in. Jasper, remember me?
Who is this?
Beats me. Kermit.
Hey, wait a minute.
It's me, Tubby.
Now, boss, you sit down, semi.
Tubby? Hey, what happened to you? You're skinny.
Yeah, food in prison wasn't so good. I got sick, too. I had to take off a few pounds. Times have changed.
Have they? And what about my truck?
I hear you're doing very well, both of you.
You're doing one better than I am. Maybe you know something about it.
Trucks?
Yeah, trucks.
I don't know anything about trucks anymore. Flowers is my specialty.
Flowers?
You didn't send Jasper a telegram?
Why, no. I was just out for a walk, and I saw the sign outside, Sykes Trucking.
Oh. Hey, Tubby, if you were still in the hijacking business, where would you stash a hot truck?
Oh, same old place, I guess. You know, that blind up along the ridge route.
Now, boss! Now, semi. Come along for a ride, Tubby?
Oh, no, thanks. I need my rest. I start work tomorrow.
Dick, are you sure you can drive this rig?
I got it here, didn't I? Have you had any gas in the car?
Hey, look, down there. Isn't that a truck like this one?
Yeah, it looks like it.
It's Wiley. Let's go. If we hurry, we can beat him to the cutoff. He'll miss us completely.
hurry, semi. Can't you drive any faster? Oh, boy, when I get my hands on those...
Boss?
Hey, that's one of my trucks up ahead. Going awful fast.
Boss?
Will you slow down? Pull over.
There's no room.
Look out!
Good work, Tubby. The warden was right. You're a first-rate flower man. Oh, I'm sorry about your personal tragedy. Folks drive too fast these days. Oh, Mr. Sykes.
Hello, Mr. Frieselman. Hi, Tubby.
Jasper, I'm sorry about everything.
No, Tubby, I'm the one who's sorry. And I've come to make amends. I've taken over Kermit's company. And I want you to be my partner.
Oh, that's a generous offer, Jasper, but I'm afraid I can't accept.
Well, why not?
Well, times have changed. Lots of things are different these days. Things and people. But not my flowers. No, sir. My flowers will always be beautiful. So I'll stay with them. If ever you need a dozen long-stem roses, Jasper, you know where I'll be.
Serling. Close your eyes, exercise your imagination, and join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
Once Upon a Truck is an original radio drama adopted by Sue Donham. Joe Campanella was heard as Tubby Garfinkel. Featured in the cast were Peggy Walton, Ben Wright, Byron Kane, Dawes Butler, Jim Bowles, and Keith Walker. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Colas, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman, Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System. Thank you.